Hi students, this is Alex here. In this video, we are going to solve a differential equation using method of undetermined coefficients. As a first part, we have to rewrite the equation. The first term is d square, second term is 2d, and third term is 4 into y equal to, we have 13 cos of 4x minus 2. Now, auxiliary equation will be m square plus 2m plus 4, which is equal to 0. Now the product is 4 sum is 2, we cannot factorize, so we have to use the quadratic equation formula, which is minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac whole divided by 2a. So the value of a is 1, b is 2 and c is 4. By substituting this, we get minus 2 plus or minus root of b square minus 4a and c whole divided by 2a. So 2 into 1. So we get m is equal to minus 2 plus or minus root of 4 minus 16 whole divided by 2. And inside the root, we get minus 12. So minus 2 plus or minus root of minus 12 divided by 2. Now this can be written as minus 2 plus or minus root of 12 and I divided by 2. And once again, this root 12 is 4 into 3. And when I take 4 outside the root, we get 2 and remaining root 3 whole divided by 2. By dividing individually, we also have I here. By dividing individually, we get minus 1 plus or minus I root 3. So this is of the form alpha plus or minus I beta. So the value of alpha is minus 1 and beta is root 3. So the complementary function gives e power alpha x into c1 cos beta x plus c2 sine beta x. So by substituting this value, we get the first term e power minus x into c1 cos root 3x plus c2 sine root 3x. Now the solution set consists of two elements. One is the term with c1 is e power minus x into cos root 3x, and another is e power minus x into sine root 3x. But the right hand side of the equation, we have 13 cos 4x minus 2. So we can say the term cos of 4x minus 2 is not a part of the solution set S. Therefore, we have to assume the particular integral as C3 cos 4x minus 2 plus C4 sine of 4x minus 2. Now, we have to find its derivative. The first derivative will give cos derivative minus sine, and into 4 will come. So minus 4c3 cos derivative sine. So actually minus sine, so minus we have written sine 4x minus 2. And here it is 4c4 into cos of 4x minus 2. Then its second derivative y double dash of p is again into 4 will come, so minus 16c3 derivative of sine is cos, so cos 4x minus 2. In the next term will become minus sine, so into 4 will come, so minus 16c4 into sine of 4x minus 2. Now we have to substitute this first derivative, second derivative and the value of y in the question. So first term is y double dash. So this entire term will come as it is. That is minus 16 c3 into cos of 4x minus 2 plus, sorry, minus 16c4 sine of 4x minus 2. Then we have plus 2y dash. So y dash is here. If I put into 2, I will get minus 8c3 sine of 4x minus 2, then plus 8c4 cos of 4x minus 2, and the last term is plus 4y. So we have to multiply this with 4. So 4c3 cos of 4c3 cos of 4x minus 2 and plus 4c4 sine of 4x minus 2 plus 4c4 sine of 4x minus 2. And on the other side, right hand side, we have 13 cos of 4x minus 2. So that is equal to 13 cos of 4x minus 2. Now let's compare the cos 4x minus 2 terms on both the sides so that I can equate the coefficients. So here minus 16c3 plus 8c4 plus 4c3, that gives 13. And let's add the like terms. So minus 12c3 plus 8c4 gives 13. Let's take this as a first equation. In the same way, we have to compare the coefficients of sine 4x minus 2 term on both the sides. So in the left hand side, we have minus 16c4. So minus 16c4. Then we have minus 8c3. Minus 8c3. Then we have plus c4. Plus 4c4. And on the right hand side, we don't have sine term, so it's 0. Now adding the like terms, the first term is minus 8c3 as it is, then minus 12c4 equal to 0, and this is our second equation. Now we have to solve this to find c3 and c4. Let's make the same coefficient. This is 12, so first equation, if I multiply into 2, I'll get 24, and second equation, I have to multiply into 3 to get 24. So first equation, minus 24c3 plus 8 2s are 16c4 and 13 into 2, 26. Second equation into 3, use minus 24c3, 12 3, 36, then c4, and other side it is 0. And we have to subtract this. So for subtraction, we have to change the sign of the second terms. By changing it, this will become plus, and this will become plus, and we can cancel the plus 24c3 and minus 24c3, and the rest of the term is nothing but you have to add 36 and 16, both are plus. So this gives 52c4 equal to 26. Now from this, c4 value is 26 by 52, which is nothing but 1 by 2. We got the value of c4. Let's substitute the c4 in any of the equation. Let's take the second equation, minus 8c3, minus 8c3, then we have minus 12c4. So minus 12c4 is 1 by 2, and that is equal to 0 on the other side. After cancelling this becomes 6, it is minus 6. When I take to the other side, it will become plus 6. So c3 equal to 6 by minus 8. After cancelling, we get minus 3 by 4. We got c3 and c4. So particular integral, what we assumed is y of t, c3 cos 4x minus 2. So c3 is minus 3 by 4. So minus 3 by 4 into cos of 4x minus 2, then c4 is 1 by 2, so plus 1 by 2 into sine of 4x minus 2. So now we have to give the complete solution, y equal to complementary function plus particular integral. So complementary function we got is e power minus x into c1 cos root 3x plus c2 sine root 3x. Along with that we have to write the particular integral minus 3 by 4 into cos of 4x minus 2 plus 1 by 2 into sine of 4x minus 2.